My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure that you hit that little bell next to the subscribe button too, in case you haven't already done so. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video. Let me show you how to take an average, everyday product photography photograph and take it to the next level. So you can use some studio lights and get average, nice, good-looking shots, or you can build a softbox and you can add liquid light and you can get stunning images like this. Let me show you how I do it. I'm going to build this simple aluminum box out of probably about a 32nd inch aluminum. I bought it at the Home Depot. It makes for a very lightweight box, about 716 grams or a pound and a half when it's all finished and put together. It's going to come with a plastic coating on it. You're going to leave that on there, and that's going to allow you to protect the aluminum while you work on it so it doesn't get all scratched up. It also makes it nice to draw on. And here I'm just cutting out the basic shape of the aluminum box before it gets bent up. I'm making it so that I have a little bent lip that runs around the entire edge of the box. You can see that at the bottom there. We're going to fold that over first, and that's going to give us a nice aluminum box that doesn't have sharp edges, because that edge is going to be folded over. So I'm using this nice brake press to fold everything over with this sheet of aluminum. I don't personally own this brake press, but I do have access to it. I'm super lucky. So we're going to do this on all four of the edges of the box so that we get a nice professional looking box that I'm not going to cut myself on in the future. And here I'm just folding the folded edge is flat, and I'm using the edge of the brake press to do that, to press down on the aluminum. So next, we're going to fold up the sides. They're roughly about 2 inches or 50 millimeters in height, and that's going to give us a really nice depth so that we can diffuse the LEDs and not have the diffusion too close to the LEDs. And it's going to give the box some really good strength. All right, so that's all done. Here's a look at the box. It still needs to be glued together, and we're going to do that in a little while. But first, we're going to work on some of the electronics. Like I said before, I have a track lighting system, so all of this stuff needs to hang from the ceiling from the track light. I'm going to cannibalize or kind of hack apart an existing track light that is going to run the power to the softbox that we just built. So the first thing to do is to take everything apart so that we can take out all the existing wires and snake in our own 12 volt wiring system to power the LED softbox. I'm going to add an extension tube that I got off the side of the road from one of those cheapo lamps that they sell at like a Walmart or an IKEA. And I need this extension because the softbox is pretty long. I think it's roughly about 3.5 or 4 feet long. And I need this extension tube to do that. So you can see the hole that runs down the middle of the tube so we can run our wires down there. Let's get back to gluing the aluminum box back together. I'm sanding off the sort of surface coat on the aluminum with some emery cloth, and I'm going to bond everything together with some epoxy. And here I'm just putting in a little piece of wax paper and some shims to clamp everything together, and that's how the aluminum box is finally put together. I need to have a lot of versatility with this light, so we're going to use some magnets to actually hold the softbox to the track light cup, which is made out of steel. And here I'm just cutting out some tabs where the magnets are going to snap on and off. We'll end up super gluing the magnets onto the back of the aluminum box. So we're just cleaning everything up on this modified track light head, and that's where the aluminum box is going to get snapped onto with the magnets. Let's drill out the top part of the track light head
and so that we can run the wires in. So this is going to be the inlet power coming from the 12-volt power supply that's going to power this unit. It has a little switch on there. And we're going to solder these onto the contacts that get the 110 volts that come from the track light that feed into the power supply. All right, man, clearly I don't want the power supply with all its weight hanging down at the bottom of the track head, so I leave that out of the system, so to speak. Here's the power supply. That actually is going to get hung on the track light, and here's a little plastic piece that is going to allow me to hang the power supply on the track light. So after the power goes to the power supply and gets converted from the 110 volts to the 12 volts, we're going to run it down the extension tube to the head, where it's then ultimately going to meet up with the strip light that we're building. And here you can see roughly where everything's going to get attached. So I'm just sanding the aluminum to where I'm going to super glue those magnets into place. That's going to allow me to rotate that head at 90 degrees so I can have the softbox horizontal or vertical. Drop a little super glue on this aluminum, and the magnet puts in place. Obviously, I have a magnet on the other side to hold everything together. Now, in the very beginning, I talked about how the aluminum comes with the plastic attached to it. And here I'm peeling off this plastic because we're going to lay down a coat of spray mount or Super 77 to help bond the LED lights onto the aluminum, because I know they're going to get warm and I don't want them to come off. So we're going to add some extra adhesive. And here I've sprayed the box with the Super 77, and I'm basically peeling off the rest of the plastic. So that's nice shiny aluminum, and I'm starting to lay down the strips of the LEDs. So I'm using these flexible LED strips. You can buy them on eBay, Amazon. They're not that expensive. I get them color balanced at 5000K. So I have that daylight color, and I find that's the best for photographing my stuff. And I try to have all my light sources balanced at that 5000 Kelvins. Next, we're going to solder up all the LED strips in parallel. I'm using some little red and black wires to jumper them all together, basically all the pluses and all the negatives get soldered. And here we're running the power from the outside or the backside of the aluminum box to those LEDs. So next, I have a little quick disconnect on the backside of the box that allows me to disconnect and connect it to the power supply. I'm just filing that down so it can fit into the hole of the light head right there that you saw. Just soldering everything together, and it's going to get a little heat shrink on there as well so that we don't get any sparks or wires crossed. It's getting time to put things back together, and I'm putting the top part of the track light together so that it can be easily twisted and put onto the track light. Here you can see how the system kind of works out. Since I'm a product designer, the only good diffusion material I have access to or readily available to me is some drawing vellum. So I'm going to add that on here, use some white glue, but honestly, like E6000 works better. That's how the power supply and the track light hook into the track light system. Here you can see the track light system with the softbox, and I leave the top of the vellum open so that the heat can dissipate out of the unit. You can see how easily it snaps off of the head of that track light with the magnets. Super easy, so I can hang it, move it any way I want, and I can also disconnect it, of course, if I should want to build another system or a track light system that has a shorter head on it. And here it allows me to rotate it at 90 degrees so I can get a horizontal or a vertical stripe of light. So that's how I can take an average, decent looking photograph to the next level with my softbox, and I can get stunning video like this. So hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Till next time. Also, for those of you guys that are into Instagram, I now have an Instagram account, so you can follow me there. Don't get the whole Instagram thing, but I post a lot of sketches and drawings and renderings that I do.
Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of the other design and making videos that I have. If you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, drop me a line.